Hello, future makers. Welcome to Teacherpreneur. It's said that well begin is half done. This is only to tell you how important it is to start on a good note. A good start lays a foundation where the rest can just flow. We teachers often struggle to find new and creative ideas to start our class. So in this new year, Teacherpreneur thought of bringing you a brand new video on how to start a class in creative ways. Let's get started. Start a class is by giving a puzzle, a riddle, or a brain teaser. This will generate curiosity among the students about what is going to be taught in the class, and they will retain it for longer period of time. For example, a geography teacher can start a class by asking the students, where do you find roads without trees, forests, or vehicles? The students might give various answers, but the correct answer is map. Once a student arrives at this answer, she can proceed with the class by teaching map for the day. I think it will be a good start. The next way to start your class is through storytelling. A story is an amazing way to share an underlying message or moral. It helps to explain expectations, strengthen character, and teach desired behavior to the kids. We have a full playlist of teacher stories which are in the I button and in the description box below. Make sure you check them out. It will be really good when you pass these stories to your students and teach them the life lessons that you really need in life. Do check them out after this video. Another great way to start your class is by taking actual tools and giving a full demo of the process to the students. This will generate curiosity and promote hands-on learning. For example, a science teacher can actually take litmus paper and two soaps and do the pH test. When the students actually see that the red litmus paper turns blue or the blue one turns red, when the student can actually see the changes through his own eyes, he will believe it and will obviously retain it for a longer period of time. The next amazing way to start your class is through a game or an activity. This will keep the students engaged throughout the class and will increase their retention for a longer period of time. For example, an economics teacher can start her class by playing musical chair. Amazed, isn't it? Musical chair can be a great way to explain the concept of demand and supply. The teacher can start the class by having 7 chairs and 6 students. So when they play the game, they obviously have a chair to sit on. Gradually, she should decrease 2 chairs and have 5 chairs and 6 students, and then they will realize that there is one chair missing and they have to run for their book. Then the teacher can explain that when the supply is less, demand is more, and when the supply is more, demand is less. Don't you think this is a very novel idea to start a class? Make sure you try this. We teachers could also start our class with the audio or a video clip related to our topic. For example, if we are a finance educator, we can take a small audio or a video clip from Beer Biceps podcast or from Abhi and Neo channel. I'll link both these channels in the description box below. They have amazing educational content. When we will do this, the students will instantly connect to the topic, think about the applicability of the topic in the real world, and will be amazed that the teacher follows educational content on YouTube, and they might be motivated to do the same. So make sure you try this out. Another amazing way to kickstart a class is by sharing a current event, news, or statistics. It'll keep the students informed, develop their analytical skill, and connect the topic to the real world. A complete win-win situation. Just to suggest, a marketing teacher can start her class by getting statistics on how the Wow brand of cosmetics has increased their sales through influencer marketing over the years, and then go about teaching influencer marketing. The class will automatically become amazing. What's it? A writing prompt or a sentence stem can also be a great way to start the class. It will be fun to invite the students to share their knowledge, make a perspective about a topic, and then have a discussion in the class. For example, a history teacher can start her class by writing on the board, "If I were Mahatma Gandhi, I would..." Post the exercise, the teacher can discuss with all the students their answers, and then go to teach about Gandhiji. It will change the whole perspective and make it interesting. At the end, I would only like to say, almost anyone can make a good first impression, but only a few can make a good lasting first impression. So if you decide to start your class with these strategies that we discussed in the video, make sure you continue your class with the same zeal and success will be yours. Thank you for watching the whole video. If you like the ideas, do turn the black thumb blue. Comment and tell us if you have any more ideas to start a class. Share this with maximum teacher friends and subscribe to Teacherpreneur for more such videos. See you soon.